Bismillahirrahmanirrahim and assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. Good to see you back. Last time we were talking about the role of creditors and corporate governance. Today we are going to move a little bit ahead, and we're going to talk about corporate governance and the community. And again, the community is a major stakeholder of the whole ecosystem of corporate governance. Now, when we talk about the community, the corporation is the workhouse of modern civilization. So, what we see is that in this era of capitalism, the corporation or the organizations are the backbone of any economy or any community or any society, because the whole process of generating income or profits or benefits emerges from these different corporations and organizations, which then create a pool of money in a larger segment of society, which then spends it in such a way that it becomes a cyclic process, and the corporations and the organizations remain sustainable based upon the input of the community and the purchasing power parity of the community, and also the fact that what is the spending trend of that particular community. Modernization and globalization also remain the world's most viable mechanisms to enable the poor nations and the people to share in the growing global prosperity. So, nowadays we talk about corporate social responsibility, we talk about community development, we talk about equity, we talk about compassion. Now, all of these things are under discussion and also under implementation. And again, through this system of generating profits and then creating a cyclic process of distributing it among the different stakeholders, what happens is that there is global prosperity, which we are seeing in the past many years, despite COVID, that it has increased for many sectors. In some sectors it has gone down, but in many sectors it has grown, and therefore we can assimilate and understand that the community is a major stakeholder. And we also talk about nowadays corporate social responsibility, that how the organization is going to give back to the particular community. And thirdly, the consumer or the customer is sovereign, and the consumer and customer basically again come from society as a whole. Now, only the corporation has been able to combine for economic value creation, financial capital, new technologies and human resources. If the community turns against a company, losing confidence on its good faith, then that corporation will lose its business legitimacy. So, what we see is that when there is a trust deficit, when organizations do not properly maintain their accounts or their documentation, when organizations do not practice corporate governance, then what happens is a gap is created, a trust deficit emerges. And unfortunately, what happens is that it creates so many holes within the system or within the corporation that then it can sink like the Titanic. And another thing that we will see is that a firm will lose its business legitimacy because it is not following or adapting towards the best practices of management, which are necessary for any organization to implement in totality to create that level of confidence in all of its stakeholders, and also ensure that it has a sustainable lifeline of credit to take care of different market fluctuations and also opportunities within the market. So, all of these things become very important. The corporation must also have concerns for the physical and the social environments in which it does business, and must take care not to take unfair advantage of its competitors. So, again, fair competition, equitable competition, compassionate competition, and also the fact that the different organizations and the different stakeholders are confident of the different aspects of that particular organization. So, that is how the community is also playing its role. By aligning and attending to the needs of these stakeholders, the corporation fulfills its duty to the society to promote modernization and a better life for all in a sustainable way. A modern corporation has conflicting duties and obligations towards different stakeholders. So, every segment of society has different needs, has different aspirations, has different dreams, has different fears. Now, it is very important that the board and the top C-suite officers, especially the CEO, engage with the community and also engage with society by contributing back towards the society, and thereby creating that confidence whereby better results can be achieved by the particular organization, and that is extremely important. its dedication to accurate and transparent accounting and financial standards, its concern for the environment, for good business ethics and conduct, for social advancement. So, all of these points are very important and they all become a part of the ecosystem which corporate governance tends to create, and all the stakeholders can understand their roles, their rights, their obligations, and try to collaborate with each other and synchronize their different efforts so that better results can come, especially in the context of community development. The fundamental basis of corporate governance and responsibility in the value system of the corporation includes its human resources principles, respect and dignity for all. So, again, it's very important to understand that respect and dignity for all is very important. We cannot make it subjective. We cannot make it based upon the car, the job, the bank balance, the different superficial aspects of either organization or of an individual. They must be shunned away, and one must be very careful about all of these things so that no misfire or no setbacks are faced by the particular organization, and that makes the organization more responsive, more responsible and more attuned to the challenges, especially of the challenges of the 21st century. And we also see the fundamental basis of corporate governance and responsibility in the value system of the corporation includes its overriding passion to serve customers and to guarantee its products and services, and also its insistence on fair treatment of suppliers and competitors. So, this is all overarching, and this ensures that the corporation works in a better way and also contributes to the stability and the longevity of the market in which it is basically associated or linked together. And fair treatment of suppliers and competitors. So, it is not only those people who are buying from us, but also our own suppliers from whom we are buying, and also our competition, and therefore, it becomes extremely important to ensure that all of these things are happening seamlessly. It is uncompromising commitment to comply with the government laws and regulations in all countries, and also desire to work with others to lead the society for a better economic standard and quality of life. So, this is extremely important, and therefore, when we sum it up, then we have to understand that there are give and takes, that there are pro and cons, that there is good and bad, that there are advantages and disadvantages, and then creating a symphony out of all of that becomes the responsibility of the C-suite officials of the organization, and also to ensure that there is nothing which is going to backfire with the community, and therefore, the involvement of the community is very important, contribution within the community is very important, and thirdly, to ensure that everything is done up across the board and according to a certain framework and according to certain rules and regulations to ensure that there is a better result of all of these different activities, and also the fact that the community is given its due recognition by the different corporations in the market. Thank you so much.